the experience was incredible. It was we were very afraid to come to America because we thought we have only 8 or 10 or 9 songs in our package, you know. But we had something else because we had 4 different colored neon lights. That's not pretty good, isn't it, you know?
Fahren auf der Autobahn, wir fahren, fahren, fahren auf der Autobahn.
And we had 2 synthesizers, an ARP synthesizer and the Mini Moog, and I had my first very short before self-built drum set, patchboard, and another thing, Fafisa organ, and Florian had his flute, you know, electronic flute a little bit, with amplification and a tape echo machine. That was all. And with those machines, we made the very first US tour, you know. And it became longer and longer. It was so successful. We were announced for 6 weeks, and later on it was 11 or so, you know. Songs, but we had to fill 2 hours, you know. You know how we did it? We tuned our synthesizers in between for minutes, for minutes. Those synthesizers in these days, they had to be stabilized every time, every minute. After every song, they were not in tune, you know. So we took our chance and we made only listening by fitting together, you know. And the people went crazy because the sound, it was only the very new sound. It was so fat, that sound, you know, the synthesizer, and so cold and so big and loud, you know. So we blew a lot of loudspeakers with that, you know, because the loudspeakers and the companies that, the sound companies that were only known to deliver guitar bands, sweating guitar bands, you know. And if you have an amplification with the guitar, that's not the problem for the speaker. But if you have an analog sound from a Mini Moog, anything else, you blow it, you know. You blow it every evening, we blew the speakers, and the company, they went crazy, you know. It felt so expensive for them to deliver all our tours with speaker cabinets, you know. So that was really new to the company, to the sound company, and of course to the audience.